Imagine making history, becoming one of only two goaltenders ever to become drafted first overall. Imagine your franchise trades an up-and-coming star and their entire goaltending pool to welcome you as their savior in net, that they offer you millions to become a permanent piece of their franchise. And then, when everything is looking up, your career comes crashing down. Injuries ruin many special talents and have made their mark in hockey history. This story is no exception. Today, we'll be discussing the rise and fall of one of the NHL's biggest draft busts and seeing what went wrong along the way. This is the story of former Islanders goaltender Rick DiPietro. Coming out of the NCAA, Rick DiPietro's hype was through the roof. During his 1 year in Boston University, he would dominate the competition by being named to the all-rookie team and being named co-MVP of the Terriers that season. DiPietro almost broke the single-game record for most saves in a game, becoming three shy of breaking it. Rick's hype headed into the 2001 draft, however, was just absolutely insane. The New York Islanders at the time were a team struggling for success and were looking for a goaltender to become the next phase of the franchise. Not knowing how good Roberto Luongo would become. Islanders GM Mike Milbury was so set on DiPietro that he would compare him to the likes of Tom Barrasso, who ended up winning both the Vezina and Calder Trophy in his rookie season. Pretty big name to be compared to. Well, draft day came and the Islanders were so set on drafting DiPietro that they made a move that would forever potentially haunt their franchise. Milbury would trade away his starting and backup goaltenders in order to help DiPietro take over the reign. The players he dealt away, Kevin Weeks and Roberto Luongo, and we all know how great of a goaltender Luongo would eventually become. But Milbury and the media was certain this was the right move. In fact, an old article I found even went as far as defending Milbury for the move, stating, quote, "He took a calculated risk on a kid with enormous potential. Number one overall draft picks can turn out to be complete busts, but if I was gambling, man, I would put all my money on Rick DiPietro." Well, the Islanders took the bait and DiPietro made history.
Ship changed. So this morning, with much anticipation, hope, and excitement, the New York Islanders are picking Rick DiPietro, a goaltender from Boston University, as the number one pick.
DiPietro would spend his first two professional seasons in the IHL with the Islanders affiliate team and would get called up from time to time due to an injury that would occur. His debut in 2001 was widely anticipated, but DiPietro would eventually go 3-15 before being sent back down to the Wolves. He would play another 10 games before officially being called up in 2003, becoming the Islanders' starting goaltender. He would improve as the years went on, and things were looking promising for DiPietro. That is, until 2006, where DiPietro would make history, causing the eventual fall of his NHL career that no one saw coming. September 12th, 2006, the Islanders were so content in DiPietro that they would offer him the mega deal of a lifetime, a 15-year, $67.5 million deal surpassing teammate Alexei Yashin's contract both term and money-wise. The contract would also spark a debate league-wide, however, as a year prior, the Islanders wanted to ink Rick to that same deal, but were forced by the NHL to only sign him to a one-year deal. DiPietro's contract would become the largest under the collective bargaining agreement until the Devils actually attempted to surpass DiPietro's mega deal, offering Ilya Kovalchuk a 17-year deal that would also be rejected by the NHL due to salary cap circumvention. As all this was happening, however, DiPietro was slowly making a name for himself. The following year in 2007, he would break the Islanders' franchise record by making 56 saves in one single game, previously held by Felix Potvin. DiPietro was also looking better performance-wise as well, that is, until later in the season, where DiPietro would suffer a brutal hit that would cause the downfall of his career. Canadiens forward Steve Bajin would collide with DiPietro, causing him to leave the game with a concussion. Normally, you wouldn't see players return early after facing a hit like that, but DiPietro suited back up 4 games later, and that would be a decision he'll forever regret, as he would once again face yet another concussion after facing off against the New York Rangers. If that wasn't a sign he should probably stay off the ice and recover, then I don't know what is. DiPietro's decision? Play in the playoffs against the Buffalo Sabres. The Islanders would lose in 5 games, and DiPietro would require surgery for that torn labrum. That 2007 season was the start of a string of injuries to come. DiPietro would get to take part in his first and only All-Star skills competition after Martin Brodeur dropped out. The outcome? An injured hip, as he would actually injure himself in the shootout competition the night before the actual All-Star game. you can't write that.
Oh my god, dude, I just blew my whole leg off. I just fucked my hip up again.
DiPietro would eventually stop playing when the Islanders had no shot at the postseason and would once again get a surgery, this time on that same hip. These injuries would only become more frequent and impactful as DiPietro would announce during that same offseason on a show called Bubba the Love Sponge that he would be undergoing knee surgery as well. DiPietro would sit out the first four games of the 08-09 season, come back, play three games, and then once again get injured during the third period of an Islanders-Panthers game and was placed on injury reserve for an undisclosed lower body injury. He would come back and once again repeat the cycle, eventually sitting out the remainder of the season. Over the next few seasons, DiPietro would struggle from the following: the flu, knee swelling, and more knee swelling. He would return once again in the 2010-11 season after missing time due to his knee swelling and would arrive just in time to play Pittsburgh, where he would win in the shootout. Speaking of shootouts, DiPietro was actually in a goaltender battle with Dwayne Roloson, as Roloson was playing consistently in Rick's absence during October through December. But once again, in confirmation and trust in DiPietro, the Islanders would trade Roloson to Tampa, making DiPietro the bona fide starter. 2 months later, DiPietro's most infamous injury would occur against the Pittsburgh Penguins as he would take part in a goaltender fight versus Penguins goaltender Brent Johnson. Rick was knocked out cold, suffering from a broken jaw and, you guessed it, more knee swelling. He would miss a few weeks, then finish the season off back in action, but his job was far from safe, as the following season, DiPietro would have to take down both Al Montoya and Evgeny Nabokov to win the starting job. He would lose out to Montoya, becoming the backup. On November of 2011, DiPietro would tear his groin and had to miss the remainder of that season due to a hernia surgery. This would officially mark the end of DiPietro's up and down NHL career.
All right, how hard is it to get back to the top once you've been knocked down? Hockey player Rick DiPietro made his way through Bridgeport on his way to the top, to the NHL. He got a big contract with the New York Islanders and then several injuries, and eventually he got the label of bust. But now he's back in Bridgeport, persevering. John Pearson spent some time with him today at the Sound Tigers practice and joins us now. John?
DiPietro was waived and sent down to Bridgeport with still 8 years left on his mega contract he signed back in 2006. In just his first game as a starter, he would leave the game after giving up 7 goals in the first period. He was never to be seen again, as a month later, the Islanders announced that DiPietro would be placed on unconditional waivers and have the remainder of his contract bought out. To this day, he's still getting paid $1.5 million by the Islanders due to the buyout. Even after all of what happened, the Checkers did offer DiPietro a professional tryout, but he failed to stay on the team and earn a contract. Rickety DiPietro, as they called him, saw his professional career come to an end. The story of Rick DiPietro is both heartbreaking and upsetting. The promise and hype for this guy was so high, yet everything came crashing down. DiPietro's long history of injuries prevented him from living his career to the fullest. Imagine what DiPietro could have been if it wasn't for his countless reoccurrences with past injuries. If he just sat out and avoided playing the Rangers or avoiding the goaltender fight, things could have been completely different from what they are now. Regardless, the man has done things most people can never say they've done. Two things, actually. Play in the NHL and get paid $1.5 million a year to sit at home and watch TV. DiPietro actually runs a radio show on ESPN 98.7 in New York City, and he tells countless tales from his NHL journey. It's quite interesting to listen to and truly gives you a different outlook on the guy as a whole. DiPietro will forever be in hockey history in more ways than one, but hey, he was selected first overall, and according to Mike Milbury, all you need is great puck playing skills, promise, and a revamped goaltending tandem to be able to succeed in any professional organization.
Oh, it's a fantastic honor. It's something that I never could have imagined really happening. Coming into it, this wasn't really ever a possibility, but to finally have it happen is fantastic.